Hello everyone, welcome back to Ruthi Studios and Ruthi here. Today I am back with a new video showing you the cool and exciting features you can find only in Oneplus mobiles. Let's get started. The first one is the smart Wi-Fi switcher. If you have a crappy Wi-Fi in your area and your mobile data does a better job than your Wi-Fi, then just switch on this smart Wi-Fi switcher, which automatically switches between mobile data and Wi-Fi, giving you the best possible speed. To enable this feature, simply go to Settings, Wi-Fi and Internet, Wi-Fi. There select Wi-Fi Preferences. There you will have the smart Wi-Fi switcher. Turn this on to automatically switch between the mobile data and the Wi-Fi, depending upon the speeds. The next one is an incoming call vibration pattern customization. Sometimes you may not like the incoming vibration pattern and you feel like customizing it. Oneplus provides an option to change the incoming call vibration pattern. To customize incoming call vibration pattern, you just need to go to Settings, Sound, and then scroll down to incoming call vibration pattern. There you will find a number of vibration patterns. I specifically like the fourth one, which is specifically good. The next one is the digital well-being. This app shows how many hours you have used the phone in a day, how many unlocks you have performed for the day, and also the number of notifications you have received. You can set up which apps to show and not show notifications so that you can reduce the time you look at your phone. It also shows which apps consume most of your time. By default, this functionality is not shown in the app list, but if you want to show it as a separate icon, you can enable the feature show icon in the app list. The next one is customizing the time in the status bar. In any Android phone, the time in the notification or the status bar is shown in the format of HH and MM, that is hours and minutes. They won't show any seconds. But in the case of Oneplus, the customer or the user has the ability or leverage to make it show the seconds also in the notification bar. That is, it will show the hours, minutes and also the seconds. For this, you don't need to install any third-party applications. You have this feature by default in the mobile itself. To enable the feature, you need to go to Settings, Display section and then scroll down to Status Bar. After you open the status bar, you have the time here. After you click it, different types of time modes will be displayed here. The first one is the one which displays hours, minutes and seconds. The second one is the default option which is enabled by default, that is the hours and minutes which we have now. And the third one, it won't show any time at all in the status bar. Since we want hours, minutes and seconds, we'll select the first one. As soon as you select the first option, in the notification bar, you observe that hours, minutes are displayed along with seconds. Isn't it cool? Let's move on to the next one. The next one is battery icon customization in the notification bar. Normally in any Android phone, the battery charging is displayed in the status bar in the form of a battery bar, which shows the amount of the charging that is remaining in the battery. If you want to customize the battery, how it looks and feels in the notification bar, you need to install third-party applications. But in the case of Oneplus, they are not needed. You can customize the way it looks in the status bar. For that, you need to go to System Settings, the Display section, and scroll down to status bar. So here you have an option called battery style. Currently it is selected as battery bar, which we are seeing now. There are two more options called battery circle and battery hidden. Battery hidden will not show any battery status or the charging status in the status bar. But in the case of battery circle, it will display the same battery bar in the form of a circle. Yes, as you can see now. So this is the circle. And also we have the leverage to show the amount of battery percentage. The option is show battery percentage. If you enable this option along with the battery circle, you will see the battery percentage here, which is very nice. Let's move on to the next one. The next one is the audio tuner. The audio tuner is one of the best feature in Oneplus mobiles if you use headphones a lot. When you connect headphones to the mobile, you will be given the option to select what type of headphones you have connected. Depending upon your selection, the equalizer will be adjusted automatically so that you will have the best possible sound and music experience. The next one is displaying the live network speed in the status bar. If you are using Wi-Fi or mobile data and want to know the live speed of the connection, then Oneplus has the ability to display the ongoing transfer speed in the status bar itself. To enable this feature, just go to Settings, Display Settings, and then scroll down to Status Bar. There you will see Display Network Speed. If you switch on this display network speed will be displayed in the status bar. The next one is the local update. If you want to update your Android version to the latest version of Android, you need to wait until the mobile operator or the mobile provider provides you with the update. Or you have an option to download the Android update from any third-party site, root your mobile phone and flash it in the device. But in the case of this, you will lose your mobile warranty. But in the case of Oneplus, you don't need to worry about all these things, because Oneplus provides or updates all its beta versions and latest versions of Android in the Oneplus site, where you can download them for free and you can install it in your mobile without rooting a device using an option called local update. We will see how it is done. Oneplus releases its updated versions in the website directly for the users to download and install them. You can download it and install without losing any license, which is very easy. Installing the local update is very simple. For this, you need to go to System Settings and then scroll down to System. Then scroll down again to go to System Update and then press on the gear icon where you can see the local upgrade option. The package you downloaded from the site will be displayed there. You can easily install it with one click. You will be upgraded to the latest version after reboot. The next one is the long screenshot. If you want to take a long screenshot of your chatting, for example, Oneplus provides the option within by eliminating the installing of third-party apps. When a screenshot is taken, an extended screenshot thumbnail is shown at the bottom. When you click on it, it will start scrolling the screen automatically and takes the long screenshot. When you are done, just click anywhere on the screen to stop scrolling and the image will be saved automatically. This will be useful when you want to capture multiple screens at the same time. The next one is internal screen recorder. There are many third-party applications in the market to record screen, but they have their own limitations. Oneplus provides this feature internally without the need to install any third-party applications. You can simply run it from the notification icon and start recording. A small banner will be displayed to control the recording. We can simply go to the settings by clicking on the gear icon. Let's see its capabilities one by one. It can record up to a maximum resolution of 2160p starting from 540p. You can also adjust the bitrate to 20 Mbps. Higher bitrates result in larger files. And coming to the number of frames, you can only record up to 30 frames per second, but not 60 frames per second, which is a little bad. And the coolest thing about it is recording of internal audio. Normally, screenshot applications won't allow to record internal device audio, but this one smoothly records internal audio, which is very useful while playing games with music. And there is also an option to show the touch feedback which is displayed in the recorded video whenever you touch the screen while recording. Overall, this is the best alternative to external applications and I like it myself very much. You can also use it very easily and it is self-explanatory. So that's all about the content, guys. If you know any other features rather than the ones I discussed here, please comment them in the comment section below and see you in the next one. Bye bye.